G'day folks, in this video we're having a look at some of the inserts that I use and how I use them. That one is what I would call a profiling insert. That one is certainly not a profiling insert, but it does its job really well. Here you can see it's knocking the hex off a steel bolt, and the strength of the nose of the insert really helps it get the job done quite well. This is taking a while, but remember I only have half a horsepower at the spindle, and this was right up there on the 5 amps that the motor's rated for. Now I would not use this insert on a steel hex, but on brass hex I use it all the time. And I like it particularly because it allows me to do these 45 degree back chamfers, either on a thread or just on the end of the part itself. Here you can see there's just 5 degrees of clearance on the back edge of the insert. This lets you see just how much more robust the point is on the 80 degree insert. Those odd shapes you see just a little back from the cutting edges, they actually stick up. They're chip breakers. And this is a good general purpose insert that I imagine a lot of people would have. This tool holder and the one for the 80 degree insert, they actually came with the tool kit that came with my original Hercus lathe when I bought it used. Here you can see a 55 degree insert making a brass part. Even allows me to do a 65 degree chamfer on the back edge, which you can see on that part if you look closely. Here you can see the 5 degrees clearance on the back edge of the insert. Here I've made some clips of the three inserts facing. You can see the pointier ones, they sort of work like a parting tool as much as anything, because they're cutting on the back edge. Now if I was doing that in steel, that would be vibrating something horrible. You'll see the 80 degree insert does part off really well. As I said, I always use full form inserts when I'm cutting threads. I never use a single point. So I thought I'd take this opportunity to lay one over the other, as you can see here, and you can see how much deeper you have to cut the thread if you're using a single point tool compared with a full form insert. And on to grooving inserts. I only discovered these relatively recently. They fit into threading boring bars or external holders, and they make great grooves, which is what they're made to do, so they should. And on to left-handed boring bars, which I really like because they allow you to see what you're doing when you're boring. Just have to remember to reverse the direction of your machine. Left-handed boring bar again. Here I'm using it because my turret wasn't functioning, and this allowed me to hold it in a gang block to do the turning and then use the turret, which wasn't working, to hold my parting tool. Now on to some inserts I recently purchased on eBay. I'd not seen them before. They're both for aluminium, but I'd never seen this shape before. I've seen that shape before. I've been using it for years. That's a Sumitomo insert. And it just struck me as the new one, or one I'd only just seen, looked like it. This insert looks polished, supposedly for aluminium, with the ability to cut sideways. Might need a video to compare it with this one from Sumitomo, which actually does cut sideways. You can see there's cutting edges left, right, and on the front. This is a 55 degree diamond insert that I've had for quite some time now, but I've not had a chance to test it. That's probably another video. I can't believe that this has a Christmas tree, I mean chip breaker, in the middle of it, and it's got such a rounded cutting edge. There's no edge there at all, it's just like big radius. Oh well, we'll see how it goes. Thank you for watching.